Okay, let's get a good look at your revised island. This is now 11 feet long, and you've got 5 feet from the stairs to where the island begins, and about 5 feet from where the that wall between the dining area and the mudroom also. And then on your, I'm going to switch to the floor plan for just a sec here. We've got 5.5 feet from the back edge of this countertop to where your beam is here, where the rooms meet. Let's go back to 3D. Take a look at the front side of the island. This is going to look great, by the way. We just got to pick you. I'll show you the catalog. We'll look at the turning styles, bracket styles for holding up the countertop. The island's a little bit smaller, but still very sizable. Don't know why that one cabinet's looking at different colors. And the way I'm also going to include some photographs for you to see of how I did this in another line, in another kitchen, and the way we wrap the material around the ends, and I've got it all figured out. This can really look great. So basically all you lost was one cabinet, and that made this a fairly large cabinet, so maybe you want to make that a four-drawer base. You have room for all your miscellaneous flatware and utensils, or we can combine these two drawers, and that becomes a three-drawer base. Twin waste cabinet, dishwasher, an open cabinet for whatever you might need there. All right, I think this looks really good, and I hope you do too. Here's some photographs of a very similar island, so that's why I wanted to include that here. You'll see the way it's constructed with the taller bar area, the wains on the back. In this particular case, we needed this column for support, and the other one is purely decorative. All right, this is an important thing to say. So I'm going to, instead of using drywall, what I recommend is we use matching material for, so the wains panel is here, and then this is matching wood also to match the end of the cabinets. And then on the inside, I'm going to return at the ends of the island a little bit of the same material, and that's going to give you a place to put your tile backsplash. All right. And I think that shows you a pretty good real-life, whoops, that's just a spice cabinet, real-life application of what I'm talking about. All right. Let's get rid of that and that, and you see what I mean. That's the way I want to construct the ends here, except in your case we're going to use these split turnings also if you want. Okay, thank you.